Public segment tonight. Let's get right to Fox News political analyst Charles Krauthammer, joins us from Washington. So, just moments away from the State of the Union, I think you and I agree not too many people are going to pay close attention to it. A lot of things going against the president right now. Do you have any advice for him?
Well, there's very little he can do rhetorically. I mean, that's sort of the failure of his presidency. That's been the nemesis of his presidency. He's imagined himself from the very beginning, from his rise, when he ran as a rhetorical, charismatic president who could change the world with his words. You know, that speech he gave in Germany before he was nominated, the speech he gave in Cairo after he became president, all these things that he thought would change the world. And he's realized, it's taken him 5 years, that you can't change the world with words. He's not the politician you need to get things done. And he's basically going to admit it in the State of the Union when he says, I'm going to have to wield the pen, do a little bit of executive orders here and there, because I can't move the Congress, meaning I can't move the country. The words he once had will not succeed in moving it. And that's where he is. That's why, in that long New Yorker interview, the impression you got, 17,000 words, was a man who realizes that his presidency has been a failure.
Now, I believe that one of the reasons he has had such difficulty in convincing Congress to work with him, actually, there are two reasons. Number one, it goes against his personal grain. He doesn't like to do that. He's not a schmoozer. He's not like Ronald Reagan taking Tip O'Neill and giving him the little headlock or whatever, you know? And the second reason is that he's so ideologically opposed to conservative Americans. His vision of income equality and redistribution is so, he's so passionate about that. And it's so opposite what the Republican Party stands for, that there's really little common ground.
Look, I think you're right. It's means and ends. The means, he's not the schmoozer. I don't think he's ever given anybody a noogie in his life, let alone a Republican congressman. And second, it is his ends. He is extremely, intensely ideological. And when you listen to him in public, you never hear him give credit to the conservative side of any argument. Any argument that it at least is respectful of the country and has the national interest in mind, although it might be based on the bad assumptions, which is what I think everybody owes the other side. You owe him a presumption of good faith, but you say your arguments are not strong. That's not Obama. Obama says the Republicans think of the next election, not the next generation. Obama says, I think of the national interest, and they think only of their own power and what they can do.
But it's more than that. It's more personal than that. His acolytes go out, and he has to be with his approval, and say conservative and Republicans are attacking women. Conservatives and Republicans hate the poor. Conservatives and Republicans are basically unfair, cruel people trying to do damage to the nation. Once you stake out that territory, you can't then come in and say, hey, why don't you give me a break and support this? Let's see how it works.
No, I think that's very true. His very ideology would make it hard to sidle up to Republicans, but he doesn't like sidling up to anybody in the first place.
No, he doesn't even sidle to Democrats.
You wonder whether he thinks, you know, he applied for the job, he saw an ad for it in the paper, President of the United States, and now he realizes it's not exactly for him.
Well, I don't know if he ever knew what it entailed anyway, because he was a young senator when he was elected. All right, I got to go in there, you know, to the White House on Sunday. I don't think he's going to give me an abruzzo, but that's okay. You know, I'm a...
If he gives you a noogie, that'll be worth 10 points.
He's going to need a stepladder to do that.
We'll give him a stepladder, and that'll give him 10 points in approval rating. All right, here's the question you got to ask.
First question from Krauthammer. First question.
Mr. President, in 2008, you once said that Ronald Reagan was a consequential president historically in a way that a Bill Clinton was not. Sir, when history writes about you, will you be a Reagan or will you be a Clinton?
Wow, that's a little philosophical. I only have 15 minutes. He could do about 45 minutes with that, I think.
And you're a simple man, so you may not
True,
be able
and I
to
might get confused very,
exactly.
very quickly on
Look,
that.
Look, I'll write it out for you, so it'll be
please
easier.
Please do, Charles. Okay. Now, we are going to ask one question from the folks. So far, we've got 9,000 suggestions. And on Friday, I'm not going to tell you who, but I'll tell you a little bit about it. So if you want to me to consider your question, O'Reilly at FoxNews.com. Hey, Charles, thanks as always. We appreciate it.
Pleasure.